I'm about to cut a bandsaw box, and I thought it'd be fun to let y'all watch. I've already glued up my blank. I've got two pieces of cedar and two pieces of white pine, and then the back will be another piece of cedar, so you'll have a sandwich design of dark, light, sort of, kinda. All things being relative. The front had this unusual little knot feature right here, so what I'm going to do, I've already designed my drawers in here, but I'm going to leave this drawer a little short so that I don't take that knot out. Okay, let me do a little more drawing and we'll cut this out. This is a little tip for what it's worth. Depending on the width of the bandsaw blade you're using, you can only cut so tight a curve. So if you figure out what your curve can easily, what your saw blade can easily cut, I use a 3/16, which is a fairly narrow blade. So I really can cut a tighter curve than this, but I just particularly like this. Has a nice little feel to it. So I think that is a 1/4-inch washer. But you know, you can get washers in all kind of sizes, so depending on what your blade can handle, just get a washer, and once you determine your drawer width and everything, just put that in the corner. Because when you're doing bandsaw boxes, unless you want to do a lot of end cuts, you're not going to be able to cut square corners. You've got to round that corner just a little bit. But anyway, didn't know if you'd ever thought about that. I guess you could use a coin, anything of a small, round nature like that, but I find a washer works real good. That little hole, just your finger goes in there and it holds really good. All right, so there's my final design. Drawer. Well, I've still got the camera in this position. When you're cutting a bandsaw box, you've got to plot your best direction, because the blade has to keep going forward. I mean, you got to be careful in here, because you're going to use these voids that come out. That becomes your drawers. So my direction plan on this is to come in from right here, go around, come up, go around, and then once you're done, you can back your saw back down that channel. Then, of course, you'll have to glue this back together right here. You'll have a sever right here, 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 and here. All of that has to be glued back. All right, here we go. Let's go cut it. Now you wind up with all of this. These all become drawers. Now, trust me on this, you want to number these, because none of them are going to fit into the other one's drawer very good. I just start with one being the top. Boom. Then we can get back to them every time. Now, what you got to do is you've got to cut the back and the front off of the drawer. Then you've got to cut the void out of the drawer, glue the front and back back on. So what I'm going to do right now is go ahead and glue this up. That gets that dry for one thing. I'll be right back. All right, I'm going to go ahead and glue this up so it can be drying. Then we can do some sanding and finishing on it. I don't know if you've discovered this, but I've told this in two or three videos, but not everybody sees every video. These are little spatulas that artists use, but man, they apply paint. I mean, they apply glue right where you want it. Slot like this, glue on there. You can put that glue right where you want it, like mortar. Lay it, putting mortar on. I've got a set of six of these that come in. They're different sizes. For these long things, I use a long one. But I've got a little tiny one that for little places. Anyway. Right tool at the right time. Pardon me. Oh, that just works so nice. I can't even tell you how easy that is. The first ones I made, I just tried to force the glue down in there, and it worked. But oh, cleanup was horrendous. All right, now let's just apply the glue. Let's place it. I'm just telling you, I do this kind of glue. I have a day when I discovered this. Alright. That's the fun part, pulling that back into its original place. Try to make sure all the voids are filled with glue. Helps make that line disappear. Put that clamp in the worst place right there. But it'll make it new. Get that sanded, that line will disappear even better than that. Let's see. Thinking of little tips and things that I've learned along the way. Some I've learned by messing up a project where I keep. When I was cutting this box right here, these two drawers came out fine, but it turned out I cut the void in the wrong side, so that drawer goes in upside down. And unless you are a lot better with a saw than I am, every drawer you cut is going to be unique. I don't care how close you try to stay to the line, and I know some of you are better at it than others, but there's just a little variation in enough that it makes it very difficult to turn that drawer around the wrong way or upside down. Not to mention, you want all your grain patterns to match. I mean, you may not want to, but it looks good to do it that way. And so what I'm getting at is mark the tops of your drawer. See, there you go. Always put a mark on the top of your drawer. That way you'll know where to cut the void at. I did that twice before I actually finally learned to do this. But I was able to correct the second one. But this one, these things are so unique. Yeah, there's no second chance with them. But anyway, just thought I'd point that out. Mark the top. I'm going to only show you doing one drawer. I know you don't want to see me do four of them the same thing. But anyway, what I've done is I've sanded this a little bit. You do your final sanding once you do glue your front and back on. What we're fixing to do now is cut off the back and the front. Now we cut out the cavity. I almost edited out what happened a minute ago, and then it dawned on me. I watch a lot of YouTube videos. That's how I learn little tips and tricks and stuff. And a lot of people have this grizzly saw or a version of it. There's two or three versions. I think it's probably the same saw, just in a different suit of clothes. But nonetheless, I put a riser block in it a couple of weeks ago. And this thing here is just a little bit funky. When you go to raise the wheels, if you don't stop and think about what you're doing, this will open up on you. And I was down low a minute ago, and this had, I was cutting some larger stuff the other day. Okay, that leaves that blade open right there. Well, I mean, I'm standing here right now and I'm thinking about it, and it makes sense to check this every time. I just forgot because I was used to having it the other way, but this was always there. But anyway, don't let that gap happen. I went to reach for something and my hand hit that, and I was, oh gosh, I can't even tell you how fortunate I was to get my hand back just in time to only have a small cut. I could have lost that finger. That blade will, it cuts bandsaw bog. It cuts stuff that thick. That would have been nothing. But anyway, I just thought I'd better tell y'all, in case you, if you put a riser block in, always adjust this if you can think about it. I know I will from now. Not the best solution in the world, but doggone, I love bandsaw. I mean, it does some deep, my new favorite tool. Okay, just wanted to include that. Okay, now that I was fortunate enough not to lose a finger while I was cutting out that, or fixing to. Anyway, so we got our front and back. This is what you wind up with. That's why we sliced the back and the front off. Now you've got your cavity. When you go to glue that back together, voila, a neat little drawer. And all the wood matches and stuff. It's just cool. All right, so I'm gonna glue this up now. I can't tell you how neat it is to finally be working in my shop instead of on my shop. I've been working on this little place in the mountains for the last, I don't know, 10, 12, 13 years. I love doing it, but it's getting close to done. I built this little shop. I don't get to build these little trinket things too often because I'm still doing other stuff, but it's fun when I get to do it. I like it because there's a certain amount of precision to it. Well, everything's relative. Precision compared to framing a house, you know, where you're working with 2x4s instead of stuff that's so thin the wood could crack or break. And the worst house have some pretty good tools though. But don't ever let the lack of tools keep you from trying stuff. On the other hand, get the best tool you can get, particularly if you're going to do something for a living with it. Time comes for getting the tool. Alright, I think I've got that decoded. Now that glue will slip and slide on you for a second or two, maybe even a minute or two, but basically what we're doing is I just sort of work it around a little bit to get the fibers entwined into the liquid. Something I learned when you're doing this, don't cut these out and expect to come back next week and glue it up, because your wood will have moved by then. Cut it and glue it. Let that be sort of a one-step process. I've got some with some nice gaps right in here where it buckled on, curled on me. This one looks like it's going to do well. When I'm gluing, I like to keep a little water in it. See, after a minute, that stuff will start to get a little tacky. And then it won't slide so bad on you. You only get it to that point before you put it in the clamps. That actually did quite nice. Don't tighten so hard down on this that you can't make some adjustments. Ooh-wee. I'll take that. But part of being able to get that fit is doing it right now. Don't wait till next week. I find a swab. Be a real good friend getting down in these little corners for the glue. If you don't get that glue squeeze out, oh, good luck sanding it off. Oh yes, much better. Tighten in a little bit. Okay. So much for that one. Inside. Now I've got three more to do, but I won't put you through that for all three of them. Alright, I took my box and I set it on what will be the back. And I set my back on the back, traced around it. Now I'm going to cut that shape out. But I'm going to cut just outside that line because I'm going to sand down the tube. That's how we get all that stuff to meet up so pretty. As you can see, my cut line didn't come out real good. I didn't hide too good. I made the mistake of having this in. I keep learning little things. This is about my, I don't know, fifth or sixth box like this. I cut a few of these tree trunks. But, you know, seven or eight so far. I'm still learning things. A lot of stuff not to do again. But anyway, for what was I thinking? You always want to see your front. You want to see what those lines are doing. I could have worked with that. I could have gotten that much better. But you don't worry about the back because it's going to have a cover on it. So I did it backwards. I paid attention to the wrong side. See how that side worked out pretty good. But that one didn't. Anyway, still learning. That's the whole fun. What fun would it be if everything was perfect? I don't know. It might be a lot of fun. Well, it's not raining. So we have quiet except for the insect symphony, which I happen to love both of them, the rain symphony and the insect symphony. All right. Now, got all this cut and sanded and smoothed, and I've sanded in here about as much as I'm going to sand in there. Well, you know, just as soon as I said that, moisture in the air may have caused that to rise a little. I'm going to do another run here. Hang on. All right, let's try again. Let's answer that foam. I'm going to glue the bottom, or the back rather, not the left side, this front, right here. Anybody else spend a long time waiting for glue? Gotta get it past that squishy stage. It'll keep moving on if you don't. It does eventually get tacky. Clean this loose glue off. It is not fun to sand. And you can see it if you don't sand it off. It also resists stains and paint. Although I did find tung oil today. I know it's probably old hat to most of you guys out there, but I had never tried it before. My brother kept telling me. Most of the stuff I ever did was for protective covering, so I used polyurethane. But this, I didn't like the effect it had on these. All right, the back is glued for better or worse. I finally finished my little bandsaw box with the little knot detail. I sanded over the corners, rounded them over. Put a coat of tung oil, and then fashioned a little pull and glued it on there for each one. Put some little felt dots on the bottom, because when you make a bandsaw box, your cuts are going to leave a little bit of space there. And when those aren't on there, you wind up with all of that space at the top, and that kind of evens it out. Makes it look a lot better. But I just think it turned out right nice. I'll keep learning to do them better as I go along, but I think this was probably the fifth or sixth one that I cut. And I enjoy making these. Endless, endless designs. Depending on how you layer the wood. Just a lot of possibility there. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed this. Thanks for watching.